Hi, my name is Hitesh Bahel. I graduated from NSIIT in 2013. I have been working with Bechtel India Private Limited as a control systems engineer since then. It's been around 3 years now. In CAT 2015, I managed to score 99.61. This was my second attempt at CAT. In my first attempt, I scored 96th percentile. This year around in CAT, I scored 99.61 with a sectional percentile of 97 in BA, 99.3 in LRDI, and 99.1 in QA. Apart from CAT, I attempted ZAT as well as IFT. In ZAT, I scored 96.2, and in IFT, I scored 99.57. I received interview calls from IMC, L, K, I, N, S. Apart from IIMs, I had calls from IFT, MDI, SPJN, FMS, and XLRI. I converted calls from IMC, L, K, I, S, IFT, MDI. I have been waitlisted at FMS. I was not selected by SPJN and I skipped the XLRI interview. I joined a couple of test series in May and I gave all my mocks very diligently. I believe that taking mocks and analyzing them is the most important part of your CAT preparation. As I am working, I used to leave at 6:30 in the morning and return back home at 7 in the evening. I have around 2 to 3 hours of commuting time. I utilize that time by studying newspaper or novels or by referring to the online material that is available. Apart from that, after reaching home, I could hardly devote 1 to 2 hours of study on weekdays, but I made sure that on weekends I would slog around 5 to 6 hours. I joined Alphanumeric in April 2014. As I was working, so I decided to join the weekend classroom program. Alphanumeric to me was recommended by a number of my seniors because of their good experience that they had. I would say that it was one of the best decisions that I have taken. The sheer quality and the quantity of questions that are discussed in the class is perhaps unmatched with respect to the other institutes. Alphanumeric also provides you with a lot of flexibility. I was working, so I skipped a lot of classes over weekend. But here you get the flexibility to attend the same classes through the online program that is going on during the weekdays. And also you get a set of recorded videos so that it makes sure you do not miss any of your classes. Apart from that, there were a couple of boost camp sessions which are organized in the months of August and October. Both the boost camps were of almost 10 days with 12 hours classes regularly. And one certainly sees a difference in their scores after the boost camp. For quant, I felt that the questions that were discussed in the class were more than enough. Like for example, in geometry and number systems, we discussed more than 500 questions in the class itself. And for some other topic, if I felt a need to practice more questions, there was an online portal that was provided by Alphanumeric where one could practice as many questions as one needs. For DILR, I refer to the questions that were discussed in the class. Additionally, we practiced for around 2 to 3 hours per day during the 20 days boost camp. Apart from that, there were several resources which were available on the online portal to practice for DILR. Since verbal was my weaker section, I used to practice a lot of questions from the online portal. I feel that giving time-based sectional test is important for improving your speed and accuracy in verbal. My IIM Calcutta interview was a 12-minute short and stress interview. IIM Calcutta is famous for asking you questions on mathematics. I was taken by surprise when I was asked questions on vectors and invertibility of functions. Followed by that, I was asked questions on Indian geography, primarily the Indian rivers, where they asked me about the direction of flow of the rivers and from where they originate and where they terminate. In the end, they gave me a logical problem that how would I calculate the height of Mount Everest. My advice to the future aspirants would be to practice as much as possible. Join at least a couple of test series and make sure that you attend all the mocks at the designated mock centers. There is a lot of difference in taking a mock at home and taking a mock at the center. After taking a mock, it is very necessary to analyze it. Your mock is for 3 hours. Make sure that you end up spending at least 5 to 6 hours on its analysis and ensuring that you do not repeat the same mistake that you committed in the mock over again. It is easier said than done, but I would say that do not feel the pressure on the exam day. Even if one of the section is difficult, keep in mind that it is going to be difficult for all. I think that Placement Board is doing a great job in collecting the experiences of the various people, which will certainly help the future aspirants. For more interview experiences, subscribe to the channel. Thank you.